that Jackie Jones Ford looks awful good pacing the field. All right, next time by, when they come by at you, they're going to be four wide. Let's go, Tri-County Racetrack, on your feet. We need everybody up, folks. Let's go. Four wide, 22 of the best of the Southeast, getting ready to do battle for the 13th annual Tar Heel 50. Here's tonight's starting field. Send them off Tar Heel style. Down the main straightaway into turn number one. The 22 starters of tonight's Southern Nationals Bonus Series 13th Annual Tar Heel 50 is about ready to take center stage. We go, getting ready to come to green to bring them to life for 53 laps. Jonathan Davenport and Casey Roberts in tow right there. Coming down to start the green flag, the 13th annual Tar Heel 50 is underway. Roberts going to lead them down the back straightaway over Davenport, Marler, Payne. Ligon trying to take that fifth spot from July winner Shannon Buckingham. So the caution comes out. Robbie Moses slows there in turn number four. He'll pull it to the infield. Take two, here we go, green flag in the air. Oh man, carnage on the back straightaway.
Yeah. I'm going to watch you go to the pits.
8, 9, 10 cars involved. Major melee on the back straightaway. David Payne goes into the pits. Looks like the left rear is flat on that one. He's made every Tar Heel 50 race, the last 11. One was rained out, but he has made all 11.
Looks like the back stretch at Talladega.
We'll see if Davenport can stay up here with him here again. Green flag in the air, much better start for Davenport as they dive into one. Roberts to that outside, the preferred line down the back straightaway. And we'll take a third go at it. Try to get a lap complete this time. We do. Casey Roberts to the point. Davenport in second, Marler in third. Buckingham and Overton battle for the fourth position off of four. Two laps down this time by. Early going here, the Tar Heel 50, which is a 53-lap main event tonight. pass down in turn number one. Goodness. All right, so the field is set here. Six laps complete in this one. Plenty more to go. Davenport Overton back down to the green flag. Here we go. Front tire here coming off of four. The caution flag away.
Turn number four.
Jonathan Davenport leads Brandon Overton. Shannon Buckingham in the 50 car sits in third. A battle heating up for four. Jamie Oliver slides to take that spot away from Jacob Grizzle. Grizzle now being pushed back into fifth spot as Jamie Oliver grabs position number four. Kenny Collins behind Grizzle in position six. Then it's a battle between Randy Nichols and David Payne. David Payne now takes position number seven on the speedway. The field will come down to complete lap number 16, this time by Jonathan Davenport. The defending race leader continues to lead. And with the lap traffic, we're fixing to have a battle for the lead. Brandon Overton trying to put the move on the 116 of Jonathan Davenport. They got pretty close there, coming off four the last time by. Overton's within a car length and a half of the leader. Overton to the inside. He's found something in one and two. And a lap car may make the difference as Overton is got up on the back bumper, and he'll take the lead. They'll swap down the main straight away. Davenport still holds it. Davenport still holds the lead, according to the transponder. On lap number 20, as Craig Greer pulls off the speedway, Overton going to try it again. Can he make it stick? Davenport still holds him at the line. Jamie Oliver slows coming off of two. That may make the difference right there. Puts a lap car in between them. Davenport and Overton. Oliver slips to the inside. He's in the infield. Now two lap cars between first and second. Davenport moves up the racetrack just a bit. Overton trying to get around the slower cars. The B7 of Daniel Wilson and the 21 of Rami Moses. Oh, man, he goes to the top shelf now. Overton lost a lot of ground in between the lap cars of first and second there. So now that stretches Davenport's lead to about 10 car lengths. They'll come down to complete lap 24 this time by for car number 116. For Jonathan Davenport, and I tell you what, here comes Brandon Overton on a terror. He's going to try to catch him. Can he pass him? That's the question. Still a car length of a lap car in front of Brandon Overton. He'll do the slider on Doug Smith. Now he's claiming green to try to catch that leader. Jonathan Davenport, lap start to wind down, 32 this time. Here comes Overton to the inside, does a cross-up move in front of him, and he is now the leader. Davenport says no. He gets back in front of him. Davenport still holds the lead officially. Unbelievable. What a race between Brandon Overton and Jonathan Davenport. They put on a clinic here tonight at Tri-County Racetrack. Lap 34, less than 20 to go. We'll see if Overton can get back up with him, put on another show. Slower cars, plenty of them still ahead of first and second. Overton staying right on the back bumper of Jonathan Davenport. Overton tries to go to the top shelf. He's got a fast hot rod. That victory circle Moyer race car is rolling. Man, this has been a racy place here tonight. Davenport still in command as they get ready to come down to complete lap number 38. Overton still second. Shannon Buckingham, the July winner, is third. Kenny Collins, fourth. Jacob Grizzle, fifth. Casey Roberts is sixth. And David Payne is seventh. So will lap cars still play an effect to this one? And Overton trying to get that run, waiting for Davenport to make a mistake. It's been a great show between these two Georgia hot shoes. Davenport a regular with the Lucas Oil Tour. Overton now a regular on the Craftsman World of Outlaws Late Model Tour. Davenport putting the lead back out over Brandon Overton out of Evans, Georgia. Next time by, it'll be 10 laps to go. Next time by. Can he go back to back in the Tar Heel 50? If he does, it'll be in two different cars over the last 2 years. traffic in front of that leader, the 116 of Jonathan Davenport. Catching back up to the driver who he's fixing to put a lap down, who started on the outside with him, Casey Roberts. Two car lengths between first and second. Two car length of lap traffic, and less than five circuits remain. And we have a caution over in turn number two. Five to go, here we go. Can Davenport go back to back in the Tar Heel 50? Overton going to try to give it one more shot. For the mid-race point, he had a very fast hot rod. Kenny Collins trying to make a move on third place driver, Shannon Buckingham, who was the July winner here. Next time by, it'll be two laps to go in the Tar Heel 50. White flag is out, one more trip around Tri-County Racetrack, where he cut his teeth, the 116th car. Out of Blairsville, Georgia, he'll go back-to-back in the Tar Heel 50. Jonathan Davenport wins in Tri-County. Brandon Overton is second. Shannon Buckingham is third. Kenny Collins fourth. And Jacob Grizzle in fifth. Climbing out of 116, Superman Jonathan Davenport. Come on over here, Jonathan. You get your back-to-back Tar Heel 50 wins and a thrilling race with you and Brandon Overton. Take us through those laps.
Well, where'd I begin? You know, at the start of the race, Casey was really good, but our carburetor wouldn't take off on the starts, and it just got progressively worse and worse, and I couldn't run the bottom like I needed to because it would get so loaded up. And then Brandon came up through there, man, he gave me all I wanted. I had to work for that one, but that was a lot of fun, man, him throwing sliders back and forth, and everybody out there watching, man, y'all got to come check this place out. I love this place. I know this is home for me, but it's a one hell of a racetrack.
You guys had a great show, back and forth. But not just that, once you got out in clean air and away from that lap traffic, you had a fast hot rod. You could go about anywhere on the racetrack you wanted to.
Yeah, you know, I really could. The car was a lot better than it showed just because of the carburetor, really. I mean, I ran a lot better just, you know, if I could keep it wound up, but I would almost have to hold it wide open, then I'd get where I'd spin in the tires, and I'd try to back off, and then Brandon would catch up, and once the tires get a little hot. So, it was definitely a chess game where I was at, but I just got to thank Randy Weaver giving me this opportunity. All the guys, you know, Pearl, Josh, Vinny, Chip Stone is the owner of this rig. Just got to definitely thank all of them.
I know your winning percentage in this 116 car has got to be in the high 90%. I don't think you've lost but one race maybe in this race car. I may be wrong on that, but you have had a great ride in this car. Looking ahead to the future, we're going to be seeing more of this?
I don't know. I mean, we definitely got a few more races scheduled for this year. We'll just have to wait and see what the future brings. But we're going to go to Dixie and Rome tomorrow. This was a brand new piece, so we got a few bugs to work out of it, but it was awful good right out of the box.
Well, congratulations, back-to-back Tar Heel 50 wins, and I know you like to get this one here at Ray's place, and I know you like coming here.
Yeah, definitely. You know, this is home. Just got to thank Ray for giving us one heck of a racetrack here. You know, I was trying to throw my two cents in earlier, but he's been here more than I have. He knew what he was doing. Just thanks for all these fans coming out to watch us. You know, we couldn't do this if it wasn't for y'all.
All right, you heard it from him, Superman Jonathan Davenport. And the guy who runs second tonight, we'll get a quick word with him. Brandon Overton, you told me you had a Moyer race car earlier, and that thing looked like a fast rocket ship out there. Tell us how good that car was.
It was really good. We packed the wheel full of mud there. It was a handful of them last probably 20 laps. But like I said, if if they didn't enjoy that, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? We were giving it all we had. We had a good race car. I can't thank everybody that helps me, CNH Paving, M&S Concrete, Penske Shocks, Doug and Kathy Varnador, just everybody that helps us on this thing. Jason Garnto, Shaver's Oil, Keith, you know, he helps me out a lot. And I want to thank Ray. You know, this you can't. That, it's fun to go somewhere and be able to race like that, and you don't find them, you know, often. So I want to thank Ray and, you know, everybody for coming out and watching.
Brandon, real quick, your car was so fast on the bottom, especially when you guys was racing back and forth and doing the sliders out there. Just how fast did that bottom get as the feature went on?
Yeah, I think I found it before everybody else. I took off down there and spun my, I said, dang, this thing ain't even spinning. So I went down there and I got Buckingham and all, and, you know, like I said, the bottom was definitely good. Jonathan just carried that momentum off the top. But like I said, it was a heck of a race, and going to Dixie tomorrow.
All right, tonight's runner-up, Brandon Overton in 76.